Good morning, Jonesies. What's up? What's up? What's up? How are you doing on this wonderful Tuesday morning? I am feeling good. The kids are in school. My daughter's at work. Hubby is at work. I am home alone on my day off. Second day off at that. I had a day off yesterday, but I couldn't really get nothing done because, you know, the kids, they just be everywhere. And I just don't have time for that. So, y'all probably wondering, what girl, what does she got on her head this morning? Honey, I am channeling my mom, Miss Rosalinda. Okay, I am channeling her, which they used to call her Rosalind or Lynn. You know, if you were, this is how my mother was. If you was mad cool with her, you could call her Lynn. If y'all was like, okay, what's up, how you doing? You called her Rosalind. If y'all wasn't friends, her name was Rosalinda. Okay, that was her. Don't come and bring her no mess. It won't be no mess. I miss her so much, guys. You have no idea how much I miss my mother because she was just, don't try to play me out, yo. Oh, I'm listening to some jams. I'm sorry I cut y'all off. I'm listening to some jams, throwback jams, and yo-yo is on. You can't play with me, yo-yo. Don't try to play me out. Oh my God, that was the jazz back in the 90s. But anyway, back to my mother. Yeah, she was bad. My uncles, you know, she helped raise my brothers. My uncles. And they looked up to her as a mom. You know what I'm saying? So, if you mess with them, if they got into a fight, my mother was out there. You was not going to put your hands on her brothers and sisters. You was not going to do that. She was the oldest girl. And I have an Uncle Jimmy who was the oldest boy. He lives in Dubai right now because he works there. And he's married to a Korean woman. They have a child. To me, he looks Hawaiian. I always call him What's Up Punch. You know, Hawaiian Punch. But he looks Hawaiian. He's married to a Filipino girl. So my family is very mixed. I have a very, very mixed family. And that's fine. You know, it's cool because when I lived in Brooklyn, everybody thought that my uncles and my aunts were my brothers and sisters. Because I guess I was the oldest and I was always around them. But no, it was my uncles and aunts. So anyway, I don't know. I'm just in a retro mood. I think I'm looking kind of cute with this scarf. This might be a new trend for me, honey. I don't know. I might give these little Floridians here some static. Now, let me stop. I ain't going outside like this. But anyway, this is a Cafe Bustelo moment. It's just some things that I want to talk about that I'm aware of. And I don't know. It seems to me, I want to ask y'all a serious question. I know most of us are on Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, Twitter, and all of that. So when you're on Facebook and you join these groups for YouTube, you know, to broaden your channel and get recognized or to network with people, are you benefiting from these channels? Meaning, are your channels growing because you're in these groups, or you don't see no growth at all, or you see growth when you promote your own channel? The reason why I'm asking, because I've joined a few groups, I like them, but there's one in particular group that just only big up. If you have less than 1,000, they're not going to shout you out. So. And I'm like, really? But there's other people in that group that are like at 500, 200, 400, 40, you know? And I'm noticing something with these little small channels too. Let me get in y'all real quick. I noticed that some of these little channels, like starting out at 20 and 30 and 10 and 5, y'all getting real beside yourselves because you want people to subscribe to you. But if they don't have 1,000 and more, you don't want to subscribe back. I noticed that, and I'm calling it out. Yes, I am. Y'all know me. I'm not gonna sit here and close my mouth for nobody. I noticed that with these small ones, we talk about the big time people who don't want to deal with the small timers. But let's talk about the small timers who don't want to deal with people, and that's in the middle. And that's messed up because you think if you get somebody 1,000, 2,000, or 13,000, or 50,000 subscribers are going to make you their best friend. Think again, boo. Think again. So you need to stay in your small lane And don't swerve yet because you're not ready to get hit. That's all I'm about to say about that. But I noticed that and I said I was going to speak on it. And that's it. My thing is this. If I'm subscribed to you and if I'm vibing with you, we talking or whatever, and I'm the only one that's talking, and I feel like I'm talking to myself because you're not answering me back, but you answer everybody else back underneath me, I'm going to cut you off and I'm going to go about my own merry way. Okay? So my shout out today is thank you to all the subscribers. You're not my subscribers. You're my Jonesies. Thank you, Jonesies, the ones that's always commenting, and I always hit back. Thank you to y'all having a conversation with me. I mean, even some of the vloggers are showing me love because I'm still getting it. I'm still trying to fill out vlogging. So all I did was I didn't start a new page of vlogging. I just put it as a playlist of all my vlogs. And I've been getting mad, you know, respect and comments about that and support. So thank you so much. I appreciate you guys. I've been rocking with a few vloggers for a minute now, and they don't act no kind of way to me. They mad cool. We good. You know, it's love. It's all love. I support you. As long as you support me, I support you. That's the way it goes. So getting back to these groups, do you think that some of these Facebook groups are benefiting you? Explore, expand your channel. I mean, you meet new people. It's true. When people say, oh, subscribe to me, and I subscribe back, you look in your subscription box, yeah, your numbers go up, but you don't see that person. Maybe they're on private. I don't know what the deal is. Here's my thing. We all started from the bottom. We making our way up and we having fun as we go. I love YouTube, to be honest with you. I love YouTube because I like talking. I love to talk sometimes. Yeah, I do other things. I like to, you know, do hauls. I love my hauls. I love my hauls. I ain't gonna stop doing my hauls. I love my hauls. I love doing reviews. I just love doing everything. That's why I can't commit to just one thing because I'm around the way, girl. I around the way. I love doing different things, guys. I can't just do one thing. I love different things. I love different things. I'm sorry. But anyway, okay, let's get off of that. So, I'm blogging. I've been blogging for a minute, but I'm just really getting back to it. But I do put up some material about different stuff that I like to do, and I do put up fun reads. So, check out my blog. I'm going to have it down in the description box. Hit up my blog. Say what's up to me. Check it out. Whatever you want to do. Now. Oh my God, Joni Watley. Looking for a new love? Now I gotta find somebody new. I'm looking for a new love. Oh my God. Let me stop. But anyway, I'm not trying to make this video too long. Okay, so spring break is coming. What do y'all got? Do y'all have any plans for spring break? What's on your mind? What y'all gonna do for spring break? Me, my spring break is shot because the kids get out of school March 18th through the 28th. You know what I'm saying? But you know, me and the hubs, we might sneak away and do a little something together. Spend the night out. You never know. But right now, I'm focusing on getting my apartment. And oh my God, apartment hunting is so stressful. So stressful. And moving is stressful. You know what I'm saying? Because then you be like, oh, I got all this stuff. I had all this stuff. It's just so stressful. So back to spring break. Do y'all remember when I got some youngsters on my channel. But I got some, you know, some season ones too. So this is for the season ones. Y'all remember Freaknik? Oh my God, in Georgia? That used to be a place to go. Oh, that's my song. My God. Fantasy? Oh my God. Man, let me stop. When I hear music, I just go crazy. Remember Freaknik in Georgia? Oh my God. You used to see some stuff. Child boo. I'm just going to leave it at that. I had a moment. Okay, back to y'all. So, let me see. Oh, let's talk about these Tactown boilers, honey. Shall... I don't see why. I mean, I know that's your money you get at the end of the year. You can do whatever you want with that. But why not put a certain amount to the side and then have play money? People get real beside themselves when they got a little bit of tax money. They go out and buy all these sneakers for $100 and change. They go out and buy all these clothing that just totally ridiculous. They go buy all these bags. I mean, like, seriously, like... You act like you never had money before. It's just tax money. You take that money and you pay up your bills so you can have another roof over your head and your internet could be on for another month and your cable could be on for another month and all your other bills. That's what you do with your income tax money. You put them to the side. You have your little play money and that's that. And your bill money. And that's that. I don't understand why people get all... You know, big it, you know, all big and be like, yeah, I got money, I'm making it rain. You want to go to the clubs, you want to buy the damn them bottles. I go get a shot. $2.99. Can I get a shot of that, please? That's it. I don't even drink like that. I'm not a drinker at all, but when I do get a spell to want to sip on something, I'll go get me a shot and I get hot and I'm good. So, yeah, so that's what I'm, you know. My husband, he works so much, y'all. He works a lot. The only day he have off is Sunday. He works a lot. And we can't really plan to do anything because he works a lot. You know, and his job, and you know, this is what I want to talk about as well. People that work. These companies don't give a damn about if you have a family at home, if you or you're a single parent, you have children you got to attend to. If you have to be there on that job, doing what they want you to do at all times. Now, I think some cases they should be a little bit lenient. You know what I'm saying? Because to me, yeah, you're the boss, but guess what? You have things going on at your home, or you had to take off and take care of things. People act like they never had to take a day off work to take care of some important business before. How are you going to threaten somebody's job because you got things to do? I mean, I just don't get that. I really don't get that. Not say that's what's happening to my husband, but that's what's happening now in some of these jobs. They want you to commit to their work. So I'm supposed to throw my family to the side and just work so I can make the money that you give me and not take care of my family, other needs. No, that's not right. I think that's not right. I think they need to get it together. Yes, we have to work, but we have a family. Because if I need to take a day off because my child is sick and he or she has to go to the hospital, I'm going to take that day off. That's just me. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to take that day off because my children are important to me. But anyway, oh my God, God was the business back in the day. So, I'm saying I like this little... look I have on my little retro scarf. Yes, my mother and her friends, they used to wear their scarf like this. They thought they was something. And those high heel thick boots, child, they thought they was really something. But, I miss my mom. I really do. I miss her. My life would be totally different if she was still here. I do believe that. I do believe that my life would be totally different if she was still here. I was just, I feel like I didn't have enough time with her. I was 16 when she passed. I just feel like I didn't have enough time with her. So, to all of you who still have your mom, cherish what you got. Just cherish what you got. I'm thankful for my aunts and my uncles and my grandmother, even though my grandmother is... Lord have mercy. That lady there, honey. That's another video. She needs a video all to herself because, child, she is a hot mess. You need a drink around when you get around her. You hear me? Remember the system? Don't disturb this groove. I'm in heaven. My favorite girl. Excuse me for a moment. I'm in another world. Oh my God, that's taking me back. Have you ever just sat there and listened to a song and it just takes you directly into that time? Hang the sign up. I like messing with y'all. Oh my God, I'm just so wow. Okay, I'm not gonna get too X-rated, but I'm back now. Did y'all hear that Vanity passed away? She was very young, 57 years old. Very young. My mom would have been coming this August. She would have been 58. Wow. That's really sad about Vanity. She was a very pretty woman too. She was very beautiful. Very beautiful. I don't know. What else, y'all? What else should we talk about today? I'm just in a feel-good kind of mood. Don't disturb this groove. Let me stop. But anyway, I'm not going to keep y'all too much longer because I got things to do. I got to fold these clothes. I love to wash the clothes, but I hate folding the clothes. I do. Can you feel it? Oh, baby, just. Anyway, I hate folding clothes. I love washing, but I hate folding. My boys, my 13-year-old, he is growing so much. Lord have mercy. He's wearing men clothing, y'all. Like a small in men. He wears an 8.5 in men's shoes. He's pushing a 9. So it's like, this boy, and he's getting tall. He's my height. But I'm like, what are you doing? Like, why are you growing so fast? They're a baby. But they don't stay babies forever. I'm missing my grandkids. Oh my God, my little grandson and my granddaughter. I'm missing them like terrible. I just miss being home in New York. I really do. I miss it so much. Not around my, you know, to be around my family, but I miss the place. You know what I'm saying? I miss getting on a train, the bus, just riding and looking around and doing things. You know, I miss going to Central Park. I miss that. You know, I miss chilling at the promenade. I miss chilling at South Street Seaport. You know what I'm saying? I miss going to the Coliseum Mall. You know what I'm saying? I miss chilling on Jamaica Avenue. I miss going to the Valley Stream Mall. I know somebody out there hear me who's from New York. I know one of y'all hear me and could relate to us. I know you do. Oh, this stands for I've been around the world and I ain't yet. I can't find my baby. I don't know. Well, I'm about to be out because I got things to do. So, today was an unusual Cafe Bustelo, but it was good. Y'all got to chill with me anyway. So, I'm about to see y'all later. Deuces. We had a quarrel, but, and I let myself go.